Be gentle with him. He has a bullet lodged in his rib cage.
Move the coffee table.
Be careful.
Gentlemen. What hospital are you taking him to?
Washington General.
So far, so good. Now we've got to take care of Betty Oiskin.
Right, Chief.
Will you wait in the car? I'll be along in a minute.
Right, Chief.
Go with her, Fang. Pardon me for intruding at a time like this, but were you very close to Max?
Are you kidding? We were inseparable.
Are you crazy? You were told to stay in hiding until this was over. Don't you realize by coming here you've jeopardized our whole plan for capturing the blaster?
Some funeral. Look at those crummy flowers. They must have cost $1.50. What did you do, pick up an old corsage someplace?
It isn't important.
Well, it's important to me. And another thing, this cemetery lot. Why isn't it up on a hill, Chief? You know I like a view.
Max, for the past 5 years, the blaster has eluded us. But this time, we know exactly what he's going to do and when, because you overheard their plans before they killed you.
You call that a headstone? I've seen better headstones for parakeets.
Max, Chaos must remain convinced that you're dead or they'll change their plans. Now, why did you take a chance and come here?
Because I wanted to pay my last respects to somebody that I used to be very fond of. Judging from the turnout, I'm the only one. Where is everybody?
Well, I don't know, Max. I guess they just had something else to do.
Well, where's Parker? Why isn't Parker here?
Parker had a previous engagement.
Another funeral?
No, he had tickets to a ball game.
Oh, well, that's a legitimate excuse. But how about Carlson? Why isn't Carlson here?
Carlson has a bad cold.
Oh, I suppose he was afraid to come here and give it to me. Very considerate of him.
Max, let's get you into hiding before somebody sees you.
Don't touch me. I watched you during the services, and you weren't even moved.
Max, you're not really dead.
But everybody thinks I am. The least you could have done was sniffle. I was the only one who cried. Max. And another thing, Chief. How about that casket? What was that made out of, cardboard?
Let me get up to you. Your next funeral will be truly magnificent.
Yes, you say that, but you don't mean it. And besides, I may not be around the next time to check.
You get to your hideout.
Spend the rest of my life surrounded by a $20 million art collection.
You're going to spend the rest of your life surrounded by a $20 million federal penitentiary, Leadside.
Smart. What are you doing here?
I received an anonymous phone call that tipped...
When you see this shot, Chief, this is really a beauty. See, I'm going to hit down on the cue ball, make it curve around the 12 ball, go into the 8 ball, and knock the 8 ball right in the side pocket.
Max, you might break the cue stick.
Don't be silly, Chief. I'm not going to break the cue stick. See, Chief? I told you I wasn't going to break the cue stick.
This has gone far enough, Max. You told me you were a good pool player, but you're a fake and a fraud. You haven't the vaguest notion of how to play pool.
Just what are you getting at, Chief?
Did you ever see so many gorgeous females?
Tisha, to me, this is just another job. Let's go. What happened?
You fell over the luggage.
Right.
Tell me, Mr. Smart, how you think murder was committed?
Two possibilities. One, he was killed by a .22 caliber pistol at long range by a short man who was a stranger to him. Or, he was killed at close range by a knife used by a woman he knew who was over 6 feet tall.
Amazing. How so?
You found something, Mr. Who?
Perhaps, Mr. Smart. Notice, please. Ashtray contain two cigarettes.
I see. Well, then that means that there was someone here in the room with the victim when he was killed. Perhaps even the murderer.
Moment, please.
Moment, please?
Once again, worthy control agent, reap a too obvious a conclusion. If victim were non-smoker, could have been two smokers in room with him.
Well, that's true.
Perhaps two smokers and one non-smoker.
Moment, please.
Moment, please?
Perhaps there were two smokers and two non-smokers.
Perhaps two smokers and four non-smokers.
Well, then what you're saying, Mr. Who, is that there could have been as many as 50 people in this room with the victim when he was killed, providing only two of them were smokers.
Exactly.
Boy, it must have been pretty crowded in here.
Max.
We're going to remove the body, sir.
Oh, a moment, please. Much can be learned from man by what he carry on person. Please to examine pockets, Mr. Smart.
Wallet. Handkerchief. Comb. Keys to my apartment.
One moment, Mr. Smart. Victim had key to your apartment in his pocket?
Oh, you want me to search his pockets?
Well, there's nothing in his pocket but this half of a laundry ticket.
Ah, so. Laundry ticket, tell us something. Present two possibilities. One, either victim was trying to locate man with other half of laundry ticket, or...
Moment, please. Do you mind if I try other half of possibilities?
Please to do so.
Or... victim only took half his laundry to the cleaners.
Amazing. Has weapon been cleared for prints?
Oh, there were no prints, sir.
Oh, thank you. You may take body now. Mr. Smart, it would be most instructive if we reconstruct crime. Will you assist me, please?
I'd be most happy to, Mr. Who.
Judging from angle of wound, victim was standing quite close to assailant. Like so.
Like this.
I suspect murderer was holding knife up his sleeve.
Like this.
When murderer was ready to strike, he merely slid out knife.
Like this.
Pulled victim close to him with free arm.
Like this.
Seized the knife and plunged it home.
Like this.
Sorry about that.
All right, Chief?
Yes, it's just my shoulder.
Chief, are you all right?
Yes, it's just his shoulder.
Oh, Max.
I certainly hope I shot the right one of me.
Here's my phone number. And here are the keys to the cell. Call me when you escape.
Gets easier all the time.
He threw those keys out the window. Get downstairs and retrieve them. Jolly, get back in there.
did you throw those keys away?
Are you kidding? You didn't really expect me to fall for the oldest trick in the world, did you?
What trick?
I put the key in the lock and 5,000 volts.
Take that tray of food into him, then turn your back. Let him overpower you so that he can escape.
It's my lunch.
Perhaps you would rather do without lunch permanently?
Your lunch, Mr. Smart.
That smells delicious. I wonder if you'd mind tasting that for me.
Not at all. Tastes all right to me.
Well, go ahead, have another bite.
Sure, thanks. What do you do that for?
Because that's the second oldest trick in the world.
What is?
Well, you taste the food, go next door and take an antidote for the poison you just swallowed, and I'm left here to die like a dog. No, thank you.
You get in there and help me escape.
How?
How? I don't know how. Use your ingenuity.
Maybe if we all just went in there and surrendered.
In there.
Look, fella, I don't know what you
got. Okay, Mr. Smart. You got me covered.
But this is only a finger.
You can't fool me, Mr. Smart. That's a finger gun, a gun that looks like a finger.
No, it isn't. Look, it's only a finger.
You're right, Mr. Smart. It's only a finger.
All my life, I've completely memorized everything there is to know about Maxwell Smart.
Good. I have some new telephoto movies of him we just took. I'll run them now so you can brush up on his walk, gestures, mannerisms. Dubrovnik, roll the film.
Just a minute, Siegfried. Haven't you forgotten something?
What is that?
Where's the popcorn?
Ah, that's wonderful, Johann. You're even beginning to think like Schmart.
Watch the walk now. He has a very distinctive walk.
He looks like he's suffering from a severe case of tight underwear.
And now we take our telephoto lens inside Schmart's apartment. This is how he gets up in the morning.
Last week, what did you tell me in the strictest confidence about the chief?
Chief, that's not fair. Would you answer a question like that?
Yes, I would.
Well, go ahead and answer it.
Smart number one, answer the question.
Well, I said that you are an inconsiderate Simon Legree who bullies his employees and has no conception of how this organization ought to be run. Remember, I'm only quoting.
1 to 12, you happy to oblige.
Have you ever done this before?
Once with a contemporary of mine who was injured during the business confab.
Did you successfully remove the bullet?
I didn't have any anesthesia, so I put a bullet between his teeth and I told him to bite down hard. The trouble was he bit down too hard and the bullet went off and it hit me. Reflex action. So I took out my gun, I let him have it.
You mean you shot him?
It was self-defense. He shot me in the throat. I want you to know that prior to that incident, I was a tenor.